on Main Street tomorrow. Come and join us then.
With great anticipation, our pageant will begin.
We've got angels, shepherds, and wise men, Mary and Joseph in Bethlehem.
So consider yourself invited. We be so delighted
to see you at our Christmas show. So excited and delighted, yes, you all have been invited to our very special Christmas show.
I can't believe it's almost Christmas.
Yeah, only 2 days till Christmas, and only 1 day until we get to perform our show on Main Street.
This is so cool. I'll bet we'll have lots of people there, because the stores will just have closed.
And all those people buying all those last-minute gifts will walk over.
Speaking of gifts, does your family open presents on Christmas Eve, or do they make you wait till Christmas morning?
We open them Christmas Eve.
Yeah! Oh, you're so lucky. At my house, we have to wait till Christmas morning.
And wait until all the grown-ups wake up.
And finish their breakfast.
And sip their coffee.
It drives us crazy.
We've all been waiting 363 days for Christmas.
It's hard to wait for Christmas. It has been almost a year. It's hard to wait for Christmas.
Until something happens.
Time!
The progress of events in the past, present, and future.
Love!
A strong feeling of affection.
Christmas!
December 25th, the anniversary of Christ's birth.
It's hard to wait for Christmas. It has been almost a year. It's hard to wait for Christmas. I wish it would get here.
Well, the good news is Christmas is almost here.
You guys, there's terrible news. The town let us have a pageant in the square tomorrow on Main Street. The mayor just decided.
Now, wait a minute, boys and girls. I don't want you telling your moms and dads that I said you can't have your pageant on the square tomorrow.
So we can't have the pageant in the square tomorrow?
Well, no, you can't.
Huh? Why?
I'm afraid the town square isn't such a great idea.
Huh?
What do you mean?
Boys and girls, I'm gonna level with you. My latest poll shows that 1, I look better in power suits. 2, parking meters need to be free on weekends. And 3, your show is gonna cause a lot of traffic problems. Oh yeah, it's traffic. But maybe next year you guys can make a few changes. You know, make it a bit more hip, happening, rad. Isn't that what you kids say?
What?
Huh?
Kids, you have to admit, the manger seems a little too old-fashioned.
What do you mean?
What? Huh?
Can't argue with public opinion, especially at this time of year with my re-election coming up and all. Sorry, kids. Oh, be sure to remind your parents to get out and vote. Sorry, gotta run, busy time of year.
She can't do that. We've been planning this for months and all those rehearsals.
I guess she can, because she just did. We need to find another place.
No, we can't. It's too late. I don't care what the poll said. I don't even know what a poll is. Let's get everyone in the neighborhood to help. Do you know, to call the town hall and get the mayor to change her mind.
Yeah, good idea, but how do we reach everybody? Time to show at tomorrow's show.
Hey, I have an idea. Let's go Christmas caroling right now.
Hey, yeah, we can go door to door and get all the neighbors to help. Do you know, to call the town hall and get the mayor to change her mind. The show must go on.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Let's go. To the... Wait. Left.
We can start on Main Street. We can get lots of people there. Our show has a message that God wants everybody to hear.
Yeah!
Let's go. To the left.
Wow, look over there. That house has the fanciest decorations I've ever seen.
Look how bright and cheery it is. It's all decked up for Christmas.
Well, I'm sure whoever lives there loves Christmas. They would love our show.
Well, go ahead, ring the doorbell.
Please, children, you're standing on the lawn. Watch out for the lights. God has spent hours putting those up. Don't break them.
Do you think they want money?
Give them $5 and see if they'll go away.
Here you are, little darlings.
We don't want your money.
Don't want money? All kids want money at Christmas time. All kids want money all the time.
No, but we need your help. We would like it if you would call the mayor and ask her to let us perform our Christmas pageant in the town square on Main Street tomorrow.
Did she finally cancel that thing? Good for her. I've been after her for years to do that. Sorry, kids, but the traffic your pageant will cause is a nightmare.
Really, children? I'm sure the pageant is sweet and all, but it kind of belongs in church and not the town square. I'm sure your moms and dads understand, and you will too when you grow up. Not everyone is that religious at Christmas. Ta-ta! I hope they don't come back later and trample on our beautiful decorations.
I'll sue them if they do.
That was weird.
What do you mean?
Why do they have all that decoration up if they don't even like Christmas?
Oh, they like Christmas. It's Christ they have a problem with.
They sprung the light. They hung a wreath. They got angels, no man, reindeer, and a tree. It's kind of empty. Cause without Jesus, you'll never understand, you'll never know the heart of Christmas.
Once a Santa crossed in window panes, a snowy driveway lined with candy canes. It's kind of funny, it's kind of fake. If it's only
kind of empty.
Cause with
You'll never understand, you'll never know the heart of Christmas.
Okay, we'll have to try harder, that's all.
Right. Pick ourselves up and get back at it. Next house.
Wow, this house has a lot of fun lights and flags and all different kinds of stuff.
Go ahead, ring the doorbell.
Cool. It's a Christmas thing. What do they call that again?
Oh, wait. It's on the tip of my tongue. It's the skirts thing. No. Carousing thing. No. Campaigning thing. No, no, no.
Wait. I've got it. Caroling. That's it. Christmas carols. They sound much better when you hear someone real singing them. Much better than the music at the mall.
Ma'am, sir, we need your help.
We're the kids who are supposed to perform in the Christmas pageant in the town square on Main Street tomorrow.
Oh, yeah! How cute!
Will you plan on joining us this year?
Sure we will, little dude. We go to all the holiday events all around. And we celebrate all the holiday events, too.
Flag Day.
Earth Day.
Mardi Gras. Wouldn't want to leave any out.
Wouldn't hurt anybody's feelings.
Besides, who knows which holiday story is right?
Gotta keep your bases covered, bro.
Huh? What? What? Are you serious?
Well, the mayor is trying to keep us from doing it this year. Will you call her and ask her to change her mind?
That doesn't, seem fair.
Everyone should do their holiday thing, no matter what they believe.
Okay, we'll call. Season's greetings. Bye-bye now.
Are you really gonna call?
No, we don't want to get involved.
Shh. Wow, they celebrate all the holidays.
I bet they get lots of presents.
But what do they really believe?
A little bit of everything.
But if you believe in everything, you don't really believe in anything.
I'm glad I know what I believe.
I know what I stand for. I know what I believe. God's holy word will always lead my life. 'Cause I don't want my heart to be deceived. I know I really know what I believe. Come on now!
I know what I stand for. I know what I believe. God's holy word will always lead my life. 'Cause I don't want my heart to be deceived. I know I really know what I believe. I believe
God the Father.
I believe
in God the Son.
I believe.
You guys, we gotta keep trying. It's obvious that a lot of people right here on Main Street don't understand or believe that Jesus is why we celebrate Christmas. Now I really want to put on our show. We need to.
Yeah!
Hey, let's try this house. Maybe they'll help us.
I don't know. There's just a leaf on the door. It's pretty, but it doesn't seem like they're into Christmas.
Wait, think about what you just said. Did you pick up anything from the last two stops? The outside doesn't always match up with the inside.
Only one way to find out. Ring that bell.
Christmas Carol. You guys sound so wonderful. Thank you for coming to sing to me.
Are you all alone?
Oh no, my children are small, so they're sleeping. Their daddy would have loved to hear you sing. Their daddy is in the Air Force this Christmas, so he can't be here. And I couldn't put up all the lights by myself. Somehow we feel together. Their daddy isn't alone, and we're not alone either. Somehow we feel together. I'm sure that's because of Jesus, and you children just reminded me of that. Thank you. Can I get you anything? Some hot cocoa?
No, but we could use your help with something.
What, children? What can I do for you?
Well, where are the kids who are supposed to perform in the Christmas pageant in the town square on Main Street tomorrow?
Oh, I saw the signs and we were planning on being there.
Well, now it's been canceled. The mayor just decided.
What?
The mayor said it would be too busy, too much traffic.
And she also said with her re-election coming up, she didn't want anything to do with the manger scene.
Oh my, no manger scene? But that's where Christmas began, with the birth of Jesus. The mayor knows that.
Will you call the town to ask her to change her mind?
I sure will. This is too important.
Yeah, you won't believe how many grown-ups up here on Main Street don't know about Jesus.
We just got to tell them.
Yes, you do. I'll call there right now. Don't worry, I have a good connection down at Town Hall.
It's gonna take a miracle for that to happen.
You see, wait. Christmas is all about miracles.
Wow, that lady was so different than anyone else we've met today.
I liked her.
Me too.
She sparkled.
You see, she doesn't need fancy Christmas decorations all over her lawn. She sparkles on her own.
A sparkle in her smile, compassion in her voice, and love shines through her light, through a tender heart of joy.
It's very clear to me, she lives what she believes. It's very clear to me that she knows what Christmas is.
New life, if we will just believe.
guys. Let's get the rest of the houses on Main Street. We've got work to do.
Okay, I give up.
Madam Mayor?
Boys and girls, isn't it bad enough? My phone has been ringing all afternoon, and now you get my daughter to call?
Your daughter? What do you mean?
Well, you kids must have gone Christmas caroling on every house in Main Street today.
We got as many as we could.
Well, I sure got a lot of calls. That wasn't the worst part, though. It was when my daughter called and asked me to let the pageant go on.
She likes the manger, shepherd,
wise men stuff. She says it's
an important part of her faith.
I just can't say no to her, especially this year with her husband away in the Air Force and all.
That pretty lady's your daughter?
Good looks run in the family. My daughter is my pride and joy. She said that all she wanted for Christmas was to see me at the pageant in the square.
Well,
I know I'm going to lose a few votes over this, but it's back on. You guys can use the square.
Yeah!
Thank you, Madam Mayor.
A candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire.
Candle for all to see it. Take your candle.
I'm so excited. Today is finally here. We get to do our pageant.
And look, there's the mayor and her daughter right in the front row.
That's really a Christmas miracle.
Hurry up, everybody. Do you have your wings? Brandon, where's your mirror?
I wonder how many people we sang to yesterday will actually come.
How many people are there?
1, 2, 3...
Gazillions! Come on, let's get started.
Places, everybody. 3, 2, 1, go announce our kid.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our Main Street Christmas pageant. The birth of Jesus took place over 2,000 years ago, and they did not have cell phones, so please turn them off. Merry Christmas.
How the birth of Jesus came about. There was a census taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to his own city to register. So Joseph went up to Bethlehem, the city of David. He went there with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a baby.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. She gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there is no room for them in the inn.
And there were shepherds out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were afraid.
Fear not, the angel said. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign unto you. You will find this baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger. Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared praising God and saying,
Glory to God on highest, and on earth peace to all men.
Oh, come, we faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come, we, oh, come.
really like it?
I think it's been 20 years since I actually listened to that story, since my own daughter was little and in the pageant. I've gotten so distracted by the malls and the music. It seems like this stuff starts earlier and earlier each year.
You know why that is, Mom?
Why, sweetie?
Because the world gets so hungry for the message of Christmas, they can't get it soon enough. One of these years, the malls are going to be decorating for Christmas right after the 4th of July. The world just gets the message of Christ confused by the shopping and gift giving. But boys and girls, you just made the story of Christmas sparkling and crystal clear.
You know what? I think the community needs to hear this message every year. You know what? Next year, I want to be in the pageant. I want to play an angel. Can I audition?
Yeah!
Well, it's Christmas Eve, and I bet your parents are waiting for you. And you know what? No gift could be given nearly as great as what you children just gave us tonight. You stood up for what you believed and told us all what we needed to hear.
I think we just witnessed a true miracle on Main Street.
A real, incredible, wonderful, beautiful Christmas miracle.
Wasn't that great? Again, you guys did an awesome job again. Thank you so very much, because you know, we need to hear what you just told us about. So thank you for bringing us the joy of Christmas, okay? If everybody say yeah.
Yeah.
All right, good. Friends, on your right is Katie, and on your left is Christina. Would you please stand? These are our directors for this year's Christmas program. An amazing amount of work. Tell us when did you start practicing?
Picked it out in the summer.
Okay, picked it out in the summer.
The cast started in what? October?
October.
And then the full choir in November.
All right. So you guys, that's really a lot of work and very much appreciated. I think some people perhaps don't know that we do have a children's choir that starts singing at 8:50 every Sunday morning. And this is what happens when you have a children's choir that practices at 8:50 on Sunday morning. So if you have any grandkids or kids, please talk to them about coming and joining this. But you know, the kids were great. You guys were great. This is just a wonderful, wonderful job. And we thank the parents who really made it all happen. Friends, our director.